All right, hello, everybody. With Storm Site Storm Center, it's Tyler Young. Check us out at StormSiteStormCenter.com, where we are going to discuss the weather going on in Kansas right now and around the region, and what can we expect down here in Tennessee. So let's get started. Let's take a look at where the storms are going now and where they are brewing over Kansas. As you can see on the radar, you can look over, and near the Kinley area, we've got a tornado warning. About four tornado polygons is what you're seeing on this screen right now. We're going to go to the southernmost storm first, and you can see a nasty hook echo, and you can see what they call the donut, really, but it's an inflow with a potential tornado. They said that it canceled. The tornadic storm, which prompted the warning, has moved out of the warned area. So not necessarily anything has stopped there. If we look at the base velocity, wow, look at that red. You can see it's very bright right there, and you can see very bright numbers coming in over the area. If we look over at the echo tops, though, pretty tall storm, vertically integrated liquid coming in at about 90 kilograms, just updated to 127, so some very large hail with this sail. And if we look at the rotation values, you can see here, nothing extreme, but they are showing up to be about 0.3, so that's pretty significant if you know what I'm talking about there. Let's go to the next storm, just to the north a little bit, and see what they got to say about this one. National Weather Service radar indicated some very significant rotation associated with this possible tornado. So a very strong rotation with this storm. You can see the inflow right here. If we look at the base velocity, you can see some pretty good numbers right there. If we look at the storm relative velocity, same thing, coming over just southwest, or southeast rather, of Coldwater. If we look at echo tops, and we move over to vertically integrated liquid, or the VILS, 74.8 kilograms per square meter. So a pretty good chance that this storm is producing pretty large hail. And if we look at the NROTS values, you can see here coming in at about 0.42, so it's a pretty strong rotation with that storm. If we back it out and look at that tornado warning up north, this is Kinsley, southwest of Kinsley, south of Lewis. It moved out of the war area, so it is expired, like I said, or if there's about to issue another one for this storm. You can see here pretty strong rotation coming in. If we look at the echo tops, nothing extreme. VILS, nothing extreme. Rotation's kind of scattered out the place. 0.42 is what we're getting, so some pretty significant rotation. We've already had numerous tornado touchdowns today, and a pretty significant tornado outbreak over Kansas today. Here's the next tornado warning, and that one is canceled. So really, they haven't updated yet, but these two bottom cells are what to worry about. There's some more up in Iowa, but this one down here to the further south is definitely a watcher, that nasty hook echo on that storm. You know, if we can scan aloft, and if we do a system scan here and look at the storm, now that not necessarily is not your tornado, but you do have a very strong hail core with this tornado, or with this particular storm. And as you can see here, as I scan around and look into the storm, really the base velocities, though, you can see some pretty good conflicting winds within this storm. And like I said, once again, let's take a look at the 3D view of this storm one more time, and take a look at what we're looking at. And it's here, you know, you can see the parts of the anvil here. So definitely look at for the next couple of days down there in Kansas. And we're going to take a look at the Storms Prediction Center Outlook in just a moment. The computer is frozen up for a second, and give it just a minute to unfreeze. But like I said, there is a warning in effect for parts. It doesn't include Fort Supply, but it does include areas in the surrounding area. So let's take a look at the corrective outlook. Here's today's corrective outlook, and ooh, look at that high risk over the areas that we've been talking about. Goes into us north central Oklahoma, central Kansas, and south eastern and central Nebraska. That risk goes just very slightly into Iowa, and doesn't really a concern there. Moderate risk for the adjacent states, and a slight risk for the adjacent states as well. Let's look at the tornado probability. Wow, look at that 45 on there. That means if you set a point and go 45 miles around a point, you were looking at, or 25 miles around a point rather, you were looking at a 45% chance of seeing a significant tornado. So a 90% chance for within a 50 miles of a point. So pretty good chance of a tornado there. Look at the day two outlook. You can see here a moderate risk over Wisconsin. Slight risk goes all the way down from Illinois, all the way through Missouri, central Arkansas, and all the way down into around Texas, Houston area. And then you can see a general thunderstorm risk for West Tennessee in our region, and the probabilistic values on that storm. Wow, look at that 45. That's what we had today. We had a high risk by then, though, but 45% chance of severe storms. We had a 60 yesterday, so, you know, over near Kansas, which is experiencing right in the middle of a tornado app right now. But Wisconsin is looking at pretty rough storms as we go through tomorrow, too. Same thing, though. We got a 30% chance all the way through eastern Texas, central Arkansas, and over into Missouri. Look at the day three category. We can see C-text area for Mississippi and then through New York. So some severe storms are possible, but they're not going to throw them in on the day three. If we look at the day three probabilistic values, though, this is for Monday. It says Sunday. I didn't update it. But pretty good values over Arkansas again. So watching that
good
definitely.
Afternoon.
Look at the days four
the
through
time
eight.
Is
predictability
4:05
is tomorrow
PM
to look at anything
W0
right now. So that's the 17th through the 21st.
Repeater.
Or 21st. And nothing significant there that catches their eye right at this time. If we look at the watch and warnings map, this was taken at 3:25 p.m. Numerous tornado warnings over Kansas. Severe thunderstorm or tornado watch, and that's a particularly dangerous watch over parts of Kansas and Nebraska and Iowa. As for anywhere else in the United States, though, quite a bit of snow going on near Colorado and parts of Nevada. If we look over in the southwest and just narrow into a smaller area, you can see here, nothing for Middle Tennessee. Hazardous weather outlook for West Tennessee, and nothing for Eastern Tennessee, Northern Alabama, Central Alabama, Central Georgia, Northern Georgia, all in the clear. Nothing here going on at this time. If we look at the climate outlook issued by the Climate Prediction Center, you can see here the Heartland is in a warmer contour for the 20th through the 24th, I think. This is the 6 to 10A outlook, so this was issued today. And as you can see here, Colorado is going to be well above normal, even though they're having snow right now. If you look at the contours map, severe drought over good parts of Arizona, New Mexico, parts of Texas, California, Nevada, and high winds over near Wisconsin. And then the heavy rain line has finally shifted toward us. And let's take a look at the southwest view, and I'm going to speed that up a little bit so it doesn't take forever to get down here. Heavy rain is going to be affecting our area for the 16th to 17th, parts of central Alabama, central Mississippi, and parts down into Louisiana, southeastern Louisiana, and a severe drought going on in southwestern Georgia. If you look at the drought monitor for us right now, you can see, though, very slight drought, rather, for parts of the southern Middle Tennessee area. Nashville's not included in that. So that is your weather video for today. Also, we have a commercial on the air. Have you seen our commercial? If you have not had a chance to see it, we will show it to you now.
This is home. Now I'm finally where I belong. Where I belong.
And that is your weather video for today. Excuse me there, I had my microphone turned up a little too loud. So that's your weather video for today. Thank you for tuning in. We are not going to be able to open the phone lines up today for any questions, so I do apologize for that in advance. You can ask any questions you want on our Facebook page. Just simply post on our wall. We are now going to tune you back into the radar in your regular schedule programming that's already in progress. Numerous tornado warnings, though, for issued for a new cell, and we'll take a look at that really quick as we zoom in. You can see here pretty strong rotation with this embedded storm. National Weather Service indicated it's a very strong rotation just east of Kingsley. So thank you for tuning in to the Storm Site Storm Center. Have a nice day, and we're now going to return you back to the radar mode and let you listen to Wichita Skywarn.